High levels of E. coli have been found in several areas along the lower American River in recent years. And while some blame the homeless for contaminating the water, tonight a new study shows there is another culprit. Fox 40's Garsh Paul Sanga explains what it is in the areas under the spotlight.
The American River this summer will no doubt again be a popular destination to cool off. But underneath the fun, there may be an unseen health risk. As written on this safety sign, the bacteria known as E. coli lurks in the water.
As long as you're safe.
The issue of E. coli has only gotten worse along the American River over the past few years, and even near some popular beaches like Tiscornia.
And make sure you know you don't drink the water. You know, you just swim in.
A solid advice, as the initial result of a just released study found wildlife are the biggest contributor to fecal contamination in the American River. Dogs less than 20%. And humans less than 5%. Research by the California State Water Resources Control Board focused on a 3-mile stretch of the lower American River from Sutter's Landing Regional Park to the confluence, where the American River meets the Sacramento River. Some have blamed homeless people living nearby for the E. coli contamination, but the samples collected from last summer through this year show otherwise. Animals, not humans, are the main cause.
I'm actually surprised that that is even a conversation, because I don't think it's fair.
This man adds, it's easier to blame something when people see it than when it goes unnoticed.
We make these implicit biases without truly understanding the root causes. That's when it gets really, that's when it becomes an unfair conversation.
The latest portion of the study comes after the first part was released late last year. Also stated that wildlife was the main contributor for E. coli along a 3-mile stretch of the American River between Sutter's Landing Park to Paradise Beach.
It's a serious, when we're talking about E. coli and we're talking about all these viruses and all this contamination, I think it's important that the public be made aware of.
As some say, more of these safety signs should be added, as well as other protection measures.
The government should put like a shower, water. This is the time to rinse, you know.
While most E. coli could be harmless, it could lead to other infections. Officials warn people should take a shower after swimming in the river.
What about safety? Safety first.
Useful advice as the river draws more and more summer fun seekers. In Sacramento, I'm Garsh Paul Sanga, Fox 40 News.
The study that Garsh Paul referenced hopes to give lawmakers information to protect and improve water quality. We reached out to some organizations trying to keep the American River safe, and they told us they are currently reviewing that research.